Factorial notation is a type of mathematical notation that's used to write and calculate a product of a series of consecutive integers. The symbol that's used for factorials is simply an exclamation mark. So for example, if we have the number 3 with a factorial symbol, so an exclamation mark, that would indicate the product of the consecutive integers starting at 3 and decreasing to 1. So 3 factorial is the same thing as saying 3 times 2 times 1. So this exclamation mark that is called a factorial symbol is simply a short form that can be used to represent this multiplication of consecutive integers. Okay, so 3 factorial would actually be equal to the number 6, which is 3 times 2 times 1. Okay, so here's some more examples. So number 2 factorial, we would simply start with the integer 2 and work our way down to 1. So in this case, it's just a multiplication of 2 consecutive integers. So 2 factorial would be equal to 2. 5 factorial, okay, again, that factorial symbol represents a product of a series of consecutive integers. We're going to start with the number 5 and work our way down to 1. So 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. 5 times 4 is 20. Multiply that by 3, we get 60. Multiply that by 2 is 120. And of course, 120 multiplied by 1 is just 120. Okay. Let's actually skip over here to 6 factorial. 6 factorial would be 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1, which is actually the same thing as saying 6 times what we have over here, right? 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1 is the same as 6 factorial. So we can say that this is the same as 6 times what we have over here, which is 5 factorial. So we know that 5 factorial is equal to 120. 6 times 120 is equal to 720. Okay, we can do something similar for 7 factorial. 7 factorial we know is the same as 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1, or 7 times what we had over here already, 6 factorial. Okay. So this we know is 7 times 720. Which is equal to 5,040. So you can see these numbers actually get quite big quite quickly because we're multiplying by a larger integer every time our number with the factorial symbol here increases. So by the time we get to a number like 10 factorial, that's going to be 10 times 9 times 8 times 7. I'm not going to write all these numbers. So dot, 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 times 2 times 1, so all the integers from 1 to 10 multiplied together, right? At this point, we might want to do something other than try and multiply this by hand. Okay, so here we might pull out our calculator. And on your calculator, there should be a factorial symbol somewhere. Now, it might be an actual button on your calculator, or it might be something where you have to push the shift button or the second key first in order to access it. But it should have either n factorial, or maybe just the factorial symbol by itself, or it might say x factorial or use another letter as the base there. Okay, so you're going to use that factorial symbol, but first you're going to push the number that you need. So here we want 10 factorial, right, which we are told is 3,628,800. So again, these numbers are getting pretty big pretty quickly. Okay, 12 factorial, okay, we can kind of use a trick like we did with the 6 factorial. That's going to be 12 times 11 times 10, and then all the integers down to 1. So that's the same as 10 factorial. Okay. So we already know 10 factorial is this number here. So we would take that number, multiply by 11, multiply by 12. Okay, so we already have that number still in our calculator. Multiply by 11, multiply by 12, and we get this very big number. This is 479,001,600. Okay. 20 factorial, we type that into our calculator. 20 factorial. We're going to get a very big number. And in fact, your calculator probably isn't able to display all of these digits because your calculator usually has a 10-digit display. And so your calculator will probably choose to display this number in what's called scientific notation. Okay? And so if you see scientific notation, you do need to be able to interpret that as some of these numbers, like I said, are going to get very big very quickly. We're going to be working with some factorials that are much bigger than 20. And so we need to be able to interpret that scientific notation. So we'll take a look at that during class time. Now, factorials are just numbers. They just tend to represent very large numbers, especially as this number by the factorial symbol increases. So because factorials are just numbers, we can actually add factorial, subtract, multiply, divide. So for example, if we wanted to divide these factorials, 7 factorial divided by 3 factorial, it would look something like this. 7 factorial divided by 3 factorial. Okay? 7 factorial is 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1, so multiplication of all the integers from 1 to 7. 3 factorial is 3 times 2 times 1. And here we can see that we have some common factors in the numerator and denominator. So we know 3 divided by 3 is 1. 2 divided by 2 is 1. And 1 divided by 1 is, of course, 1. And so now we've reduced this problem to 7 times 6 times 5 times 4. Okay? It's a little bit of an easier problem to work with. So this is equal to 7 times 6 times 5 times 4, which is equal to 840. Now, you might say that you could just type in 7 factorial divided by 3 factorial on your calculator and get the exact same answer of 840. And yes, you can. But there's a very important reason that we need to know how to divide factorials by hand and basically expand it the long way, as you just saw that example done. Because as factorial numbers get bigger and bigger and bigger, your calculator won't be able to handle those numbers anymore. So if we look at something like 150 factorial divided by 146 factorial, if you try to type that into your calculator won't be able to do that calculation because those numbers are so big. They're too big for your calculator to handle. But you are able to get the answer to this by writing out the factorial the long way or expanding it by hand. So 150 factorial we know is 150 times 149 times 148 times 147 times 146 times all of the integers right down to 1. Okay? So yeah, that was definitely going to be a very big number. Too big for your calculator to work with. 146 factorial, well, we're going to start at 146 times 145 times 144 all the way down to the integer 1. Okay. Well, we can see that we have some common factors in the numerator and denominator. 146 divided by 146 is 1. 145 divided by 145 is also 1. 144 divided by 144 is also 1. And in fact, all of the integers from 146 all the way down to 1 are all going to divide out with a factor in the denominator. Because 2 divided by 2 is also 1. 1 divided by 1 is also 1. So everything from 146 down will divide out with the denominator. So in the denominator, we're left with just 1. And so this calculation reduces to 150 times 149 times 148 times 147. Okay. this is just four numbers multiplied together. This is something that your calculator can handle, okay? This original division statement is not, okay? So you will be using factorials with numbers this big in the next few sections of this course. And so it's important that you know how to divide things like this using this type of method, because these numbers can't be done on your calculator, okay? So at this point then, we can just type this part in. Gives us this very large number. So 486 million. 246,600.